that gorgeous Barbara in John Smith's house in Streatham, England. Everything in a nice, cool, soothing blue. There's a door, there's a kitchen, and her bedroom is over there. She's my type, you know. And this is my lovely Mary Smith in John Smith's house. And this is important. This house is in Wimbledon, England. Everything in a nice, bright yellow. Yeah, here's the door. Here's her kitchen. And again, her bedroom is over there. And you must remember that this house is in Wimbledon. And that house is in Streatham. They're different towns, okay? And this is the living room of the two households. A few times in the play, what is occurring in the two households can be seen at the same time. But naturally, the people in the house do not realize or see or notice what the people in the other house is doing. About that? As you might have already noticed, this John Smith has two wives. Is it based on real life? It's a secret. You know, women are always like that. All I had was a couple of drinks with a young gal. What does she do? She chases me like a panther after I ride it.
Found it!
Thank you.
He's a taxi driver. I woke up this morning, and he hadn't come home. He was due back at 12 o'clock last night. He was due back this morning at 7:30. From the night shift, from the early shift. It's gone 8:30, and he always so punctual. I didn't know where he was except that he keeps the basic schedule. He has this precise schedule, you see. But he does put in a lot of overtime. I'm worried. He might have fallen asleep at the wheel of his taxi. Hospitals? No, I haven't. Would you? Thank you very much. I'm very grateful. Well, he's sort of commonplace, really. Average, I suppose. Medium high, brown hair, dark eyes, sort of cuddly. Distinguished marks? Not really. No, he's very ordinary. Thank you.
Thank you.
time enough. Yes, he is, but he's incapacitated at the moment. UBI? What's that? Oh, who is it? UBI. Fine. Yes. Plot A, 25 Kenilworth Avenue, Wimbledon, SW19. Okay, bye. That was UBI.
What's that mean?
United Press International.
Press? You can't give my press!
Yes, the press is right. You are going to be a hero.
I want to see them!
One of us not. Just an interview. Probably a photograph.
Photograph? I'm not seeing anybody, Mary!
The hostel gave you some tablets. I'll get them.
I'm still not meeting anybody! You don't understand.
Oh, you're right there. Lightning, when you think of how rubbish the papers read, you deserve to be on the front page.
Stanley, nothing must be said about me in newspapers. You'll have to deal with them when you get here. Say it was me. Say it was you. Say anything.
What the hell are you talking about?
You would ruin me.
Oh, if this story appears in the papers?
Yes, I will be ruined with Barbara.
Why should you be ruined? Who's Barbara?
She's a lady.
A lady? Who you naughty, naughty, Johnny?
Yes, Stanley. All hell will be let loose if Barbara writes an angry newspaper about me, Mary, and living in Wimbledon.
Why?
Because I live with Barbara in Streatham.
No, you live with Mary in Wimbledon.
That too.
You got two homes?
Yes.
One here with Mary.
Yes.
And one with your girlfriend, is that right?
Yes. Only Barbara's not my girlfriend. She's my wife.
I beg your pardon?
Barbara and I are married.
Mary and you are married.
That too.
You got two wives?
Yes.
And two homes?
Yes.
Oh, God almighty. I thought you were ordinary.
Yes.
I can't believe it.
Yes, from driving a taxi, not like an ordinary job, is it? Unusual hours, morning shift, afternoon shift, evening shift, night shift. Well, I'm either driving a taxi and rushing back to get back with Mary, or driving a taxi and rushing back to get back with Barbara.
Oh, you did actually marry both of them, did you?
Yes. Married at the first. That was 3 years ago in church. And then I met Barbara 4 months later.
4 months?
She just got into my taxi at Victoria Station. She'd been to Worthing on a holiday, and we started chatting between Victoria and Streatham, where she had this flat. And I helped her take her cases out, and we chatted some more, and she asked me if I'd like a cup of tea. And I said yes, and we chatted. And she asked me if I'd like to come to tea the next day. And I said yes, so I did. And the next day we chatted again.
So you asked Barbara to marry you?
No, she asked me.
God almighty!
I didn't have the heart to say no.
Eh?
So we'd get married at Streatham Registry Office.
And you moved in with Barbara?
Yes.
While still living here with Mary.
Like I said, it needs a tight schedule.
And hell of stamina. I don't know how you manage it.
Look, I've got to get over to Barbara right away. I was due back at 7:30 this morning from the early shift.
With Barbara in Streatham?
Yes.
Well, what are all these letters?
I have a sort of code to back out my schedule.
SWM.
Saturday with Mary.
HDB.
Half day Barbara.
LMBTMM.
too damn clever. You put your foot in it.
Sorry, but I'm seeing you two newest now. You run your devil.
Go and give Mary a chatting while I speak to Barbara.
Barbara?
I can't let her go off to work without knowing I'm okay.
Oh, bloody hell.
United Press Association, get rid of them. His name's Gardner, and she thinks he's a market gardener. She's got it a bit confused.
Are you there?
Wait. An Englishman's home, his castle.
I'm just doing my job, mate. I want a picture.
John!
Clear up!
Clear up?
Clear the line a minute. He doesn't want any publicity. I told you.
If I called up an inopportune moment, Mrs. Smith.
Quite all right. Is it about my husband?
Yes, indeed. You spoke to me earlier at Stratham Police. Detective Sergeant Portman.
Oh, excuse me.
Of course.
Sit down, will you?
Stop.
Hello.
It's me again, the farmer.
Oh, I want to speak to Mr. Smith.
He'll be with you any minute, so whatever you do, don't contact the police.
There's a police agent here now.
What? Oh, tell the police, it's okay.
Police?
Thank you very much, but I'm not interested in joining the police force.
What?
Bye. Oh, bloody labor exchange. I ask you,
look,
a policeman.
I'm going to find them. I reckon they bang on head some more damage to realize.
Oh, Mary!
Anything the matter, Mrs. Smith?
No, I don't think so.
No, you spoke to me earlier concerning your husband. We've done a check on all the nearby hospitals.
It's alright, I contacted him.
Oh, good. But there's still one or two things I'd like straightened out.
Hello, darling.
Sweetheart.
I'm sorry, I'm a bit late.
How on earth did you get here so quickly?
No traffic.
John, this gentleman from Stratham Police.
Stratham Police?
Detective Sergeant Porterhouse.
Jolly good.
Well,
I'm dead now. Safe and sound.
Fit to the fiddle.
Thanks for calling.
If I could just clarify a couple of points, sir.
Well, I'm not feeling too good, actually. Bang the old head, you know.
Yes, handbag, wasn't it?
Handbag?
John Smith, casualty department. We built a hospital. Concussion and bruising. Cause of damage, lady's handbag.
Johnny!
What a coincidence!
Listen, sir.
Yes, two gentlemen, both getting their heads bashed on the same day.
So, this one's not true then?
No, mind you, John Smith, come on in. Oh, you can see it's not me. This fellow got involved with an old lady, two muggers, and a handbag. I banged my head on the old oak tree.
So, you weren't in Wimbledon in the early hours of this morning?
No.
Driving your taxi?
No. Taxi?
It says here, this block's occupation is a taxi driver.
No!
What a coincidence! Oh!
What, sir?
According to your notes, this Mr. Smith was released from Wimbledon Hospital at
That's right.
Couldn't be me then. I was in the country at that time. I rang you, didn't I, darling, from the barn?
Yes. There is something peculiar about that barn, though.
Yes. It was a bit of a funny barn. Well, thanks for going to all this trouble, Sergeant.
There is something else.
Yes?
Our colleagues in the Wimbledon Forest took this other Mr. Schmidt home to an address in Wimbledon.
He probably lives in Wimbledon.
Yeah, but somehow or other, the hospital had his address in their records. 47 Levy Road, Streatham, SW16.
That's our address, John!
Oh, that is a coincidence!
That's what I thought.
Of course!
Yes, sir.
Well, the reason Wimbledon Hospital have the other John Smith address as mine here is because I was in the hospital a couple of days ago and they got their records confused.
You didn't mention it, sweetie.
It wasn't so serious, sweetie. I just looked on their casualty department, banged my head, and taxi bonnet, chicken the flaps.
You're dead unlucky with your head, aren't you?
Yes, I'm always doing it. Well, it was in and out of the place in 5 minutes. It was nothing, but of course, they took down all my particulars. That explains it, doesn't it?
Does it?
Yes. The hospital have both my address from the other day and the other Mr. Smith's address from this morning. Naturally, the other Mr. Smith asked the police to take him to an address in Wimbledon, where he lives. But when the hospital has asked for the other Mr. Smith's address, they look up the wrong page in their casualty book and see John Smith, taxi driver, nature of injury, abrasion in the cranium, and give you my address in Stratton. Not realizing that, on the very next page is the address of the other John Smith, taxi driver, nature of injury, abrasion in the cranium. We just gone home to Ripley.
Well, I think that explains it all there.
Yes. You can close the fire.
I'm sorry I put you to all this trouble, Sergeant.
What all right, madam.
I'll see you out.
Thank you.
Here really shouldn't be driving, Stanley. I should have put my foot down.
Oh, she'll be all right.
I'm going to raise a certain trouble that you will leave.
Oh, I don't think you should do that.
She wrote the number here somewhere. Yes.
One of the men?
Men?
Or the sergeant if she's there.
Have you flipped your
on the job at the moment.
Driving his taxi, you mean?
Yes.
Well, I think I'll go and call this other Richardson.
Oh! Oh! Call on him?
In Streatham.
Do you think you should?
It's only in the next manor.
Outside your jurisdiction, though, isn't it?
Just a social call, Mr. Gardner. Just a social call. Oh, Mr. Gardner.
What?
Do you know what an accessory is?
A handbag? Oh, an accessory.
Yes. Good.
They'll have to make an
anything, but knowing me, I probably will.
Anytime.
For God's sake, don't encourage me. I travel from the IP.
Well, anything we can do to help. Hell is it?
Thanks ever so.
Oh my God! Taxi driver has a gold mugger. Front page with a picture. I must jump.
Does it?
Right.
little rift. Today's been a bit of strain. When he will be all right after kiss and cuddle.
Kiss and cuddle?
Never fails. Do what you're planning to do and spend the morning together in bed.
I was planning no such thing.
Well, he was.
Was he? I assure you the last thing I do is jump into bed with a moron.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I don't endow this sort of thing.
I'm sorry to hear that too.
What sort of wife do you think I am?
I really don't know.
Once you say that sort of thing, you've got no marriage at all.
I'm surprised that you ended up with little Stanley.
I don't intend to end up with little Stanley.
Oh dear.
If I could just recall what happened to my husband.
As far as I'm concerned, it's clarified the situation.
But you said you seen him, and I'd like to know where he is.
Well, he's upstairs, isn't he?
What's John doing up there?
Isn't that where he went?
To see Stanley.
I thought Stanley was at school.
Thank goodness!
John, where are you?
Never mind that. Is everything all right?
Sort of, yes.
Nothing almost happened?
No. There's a policeman here, but that's been sorted out.
Police?
From Straker.
Oh, yes?
Do you want to talk to him?
No, thanks.
No? The sergeant's quite happy, I think.
Oh, good. Is Stanley about?
I think Stanley's been drinking, or he's on drugs.
He's had a lot to contend with this morning, darling.
The sooner he leaves here and shakes up the girlfriend of the better.
Look, darling, I'm on my way right now.
Yes, you hurry back, sweetheart, then he's straight to bed.
Great. I'll be 5 minutes.
All right, 5 minutes.
I'll be off there with this man. Don't bother to see me out.
It's okay. I'm sorry if it's been a bit hectic here this morning.
All the day at work. And Mrs. Smith, little word of advice about Stanley. Just his trousers down and give him the treatment.
I feel a life
before. I'm sorry, sweetheart.
I've been standing outside the bed for 10 minutes.
I said I'm sorry. We must not miss each other. I came back here to look for you.
Honestly? Well, I'm going to make some coffee and sit quietly for 5 minutes and read the paper.
Don't let's hang around here. After lunch, read papers and have a lovely... Oh!
What on earth's the matter?
England, 79 for 6.
It must be worse than that.
Probably it's by now.
You look at the front page. It practically died.
Yes, it's catastrophic.
Here, let's have a look.
No.
Don't be too late.
No. I'll take that from you.
Actually, fine.
No. I've got it. I want it. I need it.
Thank you. Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. Dad was told by mother, you can't have one, you can't have none, you can't have one without the other.
Well, dare not speak his name.
You see, Sergeant, this dear man took a flat in Wimbledon about Mrs. Smith and myself, and well, it was love at first sight, wasn't it, Stanley? He's choked!
Well, I fought it.
God knows I fought it. I've always been awful, you see. Stan is queer from way back. But finally, I stopped. Of course, I still realized I couldn't go on deceiving my dear wife when I ran home. So Stan and I found this little place. Our little love nest.
Well, I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. I'm sorry,
John. No, that I understand.
I've done my best.
And I have no complaint, Precious.
I'm not gay.
Well, I'm not too happy about it either. I mean, it's a very delicate situation, Sergeant.
Hey!
Jack Bauer again. Cleaning the bedroom. I have to walk around as usual, Stan. Stuff is such a headache these days.
Your suspicions are correct. You
think I ought to go home and comfort my wife. And I'll try and find someone to comfort me.
I reckon the best place you can go is abroad.
That's not a bad idea.
Well, I'll get back to the station and make her home.
I think we should tell her that someone's got hold of a wrong end of a stick.
That's one way of putting it. It seems to me that Mr. Smith had a perfectly happy and normal marriage until you came missing into his life.
You run in there, oh, shut up! What about me? She just took my wife, I'm a pansy! She told Mary that I was one too. She's going to put it in a report. I'll be on police recall. I'm a boot!
Oh, built up a minute.
Homosexual! God, I have a trouble convincing some people that I'm homo sapien.
If you stay in Wimbledon, none of this would have happened.
Oh, you are ungrateful. I think you tell you that your pictures in the paper.
I know!
I turned up.
I had the blood you have eaten up!
Hey! John!
Oh, your stuff is getting difficult now.
Let me know it.
What's going on here?
Oh, you haven't met my apartment friend, Mr. Gardner. Mr. Gardner. No. She's just leaving.
No.
She was just leaving. Wasn't it sweet of Stanley to
drive over?
Yes.
Well, we've had a lovely chat.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I can't advise you.
It is not really my line of conduct.
Yes. And he'd be very grateful if you stop involving him. We're not interested in farming.
Who the hell is it?
It's all right, Stanley. My wife doesn't need to be rude.
Yes, I do. She's supposed to be our deal together, and you seem more keen to spend it discussing bloody cattle with Stanley. Right. I'm going to get ready for bed. You can join me or go back to Stanley's house and bed down with him. It's probably his cow, man.
Now, look what you've done.
Me?
Yes. You ruined both my marriages.
The only person who's been ruined wrong here is me.
Sergeant Porterhouse again, sir.
Yes, Porterhouse from the street.
Sorry to barge you once more.
That's okay.
Yes, the more familiar. If you're anything for me, sergeant, I shall be in bed.
Seems a bit upset.
Nothing serious. What can I do for you, sergeant?
I just thought you'd like to know that I... Oh!
Hey! We have a visitor!
Mr. Smith!
Yes?
No, the other Mr. Smith.
Other Mr. Smith?
Your namesake from Wimbledon.
Yes!
Oh, Mr. Smith just dropped in to introduce himself.
I bet you were surprised when he turned up.
I was actually, yes.
John Smith, taxi driver of Regional Ukraine. It's a million to one chance.
It's almost unbelievable.
Yes, they make it all okay. Mr. Smith, they are verifying the situation vis-a-vis the mix-up over the name of the hospital.
Oh, thanks, John.
Oh, don't mention it, John.
So, no problems.
No problems. Well, thanks for calling.
And I'm sorry if I arrived at the slightly inopportune moment, Mr. Smith.
Oh.
He was planning to get Mrs. Smith into bed.
Was he?
you're surprised too when he turned up.
You know, I think it does surprise me.
With them having so much in Kaneko.
Don't tell me, bullocks.
Beg pardon?
I'll be in the little jiffy, darling.
In that time, perhaps, you can resolve your future relationship with Stanley.
His relationship with Stanley?
Yes.
I'll read him. Oh, well. Mr. Smith and I were just suggesting to the other Mr. Smith that he may not care to have little Stanley fostered with us here.
Fostered?
Just a suggestion.
Are things as bad as that at home?
They're getting worse.
It might be the best thing for the little lad.
Yes. I'll see you out.
Right.
I'm sure you'd like a cup of tea, Sergeant.
Tea?
Yes. Mr. Smith, why don't you take the sergeant into the kitchen and put the kettle while I open the front door and do it whoever it may be.
Well, both of you would go down very nice, actually, sir.
Right,
Mrs. Smith.
She's had enough shocks for one day, haven't you, darling?
I doubt it, huh? You've never shown your visiting design at home.
I haven't had the time.
I don't think I'm so surprised about you.
Right, these are my four.
And what exactly are you doing here?
Don't worry, it's not official anymore. I'm being just good fairy.
I'd rephrase that if I were you.
Who's for tea then?
What a good idea! Nice cup of tea!
A cup of tea!
No tea for me, thank you.
You look irritated. I also have my partner.
Your partner?
We've been together longer than Mr. Schmidt. And his partner. We've had 20 years of it.
This is a real eye-opener. Does your partner go to places with you?
We go dancing.
Dancing?
Oh, that was a very nice cup of tea, Sergeant.
Oh, yes, it was very nice.
Thanks for the chat, too, and all the advice.
Oh, pleasure. I know how important a happy marriage is and how difficult it can be adjusting in the early days.
You see? You see?
Well, I think you're converted all too.
Mrs. Smith is a bit upset, Sergeant. Remember, her grandparents.
That other sergeant.
Was it?
My grandparents!
It's okay!
Has something happened to my granny, Granddad?
No.
Then why did you mention him?
Because I thought he would remember then, but of course he wouldn't, because he told the other one.
Why did Mrs. Smith call me a poverty and old fool?
Because she's upset about her grandparents.
I see.
John said they were okay.
Oh, yes. They are. They are staying with your brother, Sydney.
My brother, Sydney?
Oh, listen, Bassett's talk.
Bassett's talk?
Yes!
But they've only just met. I introduced them.
shut up!
A proper confession.
She'll decide what's proper.
Oh, Joe. Oh, we had it.
Everybody knows that.
I think the time has come. Hours ago.
I should have listened to you earlier, Stanley. You might have saved a lot of heartache.
Yes. Well, that's what I said.
Yes, you did. He did. Okay, here we go.
The truth.
Of course. The whole truth. And nothing but.
って僕はここの、演劇の出身ではないので、まあ、部外者なんですけれども、皆さんがなんかワイワイ楽しそうにやってるっていうのが、初めの印象で、非常に楽しませていただきました。ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much. And next, Mr. Akihiko Tsuruta, please.
どういう巡り合わせかわからないんですけど、2年連続ドラフェスの審査員をやらせてもらえることになりまして、今年度も、まあ、全ての劇を見まして思ったのが、去年の自分がデフレクの時に言ったことが比較的消化されていて嬉しかった。あとは脚本に関していろいろとちょっと感想があるんですけど、まあ、それはまた結果が出てからということで、皆さんお疲れ様でした。
Thank you very much. And now, honorable judges will announce the winners.
Best Stage Effect Prize goes to Toho and Toho Guys.
The next prize is the Best Actors Prize. Since this year there were many good actors and actresses, first I would like to compliment the nominees by reading all the names of the nominees in their appearing order. Miss Maiko Miyazaki Shoujo, Miss Kazuki Yaka, KO Girls.Mio Shimozaki Fujimi Girls. Miss Akiko Morita Fujimi Girls. Mr. Taisuke Onomura Fujimi Girls. Mr. Tatsuya Abe Toho Senior High School. Mr. Satoshi Yamabe Toho Senior High School.And the Best Actor Prize goes to Mr. Tatsuya Abe. Alright,
it's
okay,
it's okay.
Thank you.
to next is third prize. Third prize goes to Fujimi Senior High School. And next, second prize goes to Shoei Girls. And last, but not least, the first prize goes to Toho and Toho Girls. Won the first prize in the 24th Inter High School Drama Festival on March 29, 3031. Congratulations.
Committee, participating students, Chuo University Senior High School English Speaking Societies and people coming today here. Secondly, a drama consists of many parts, not only the performance and performers, but the stage and props are made the cast and staff together. So drama is any event that everyone who takes part in can enjoy. This is one of the reasons I like drama. Don't you think so? Cooperating to make drama. When I perform a part, I could become someone else. It was very interesting for me. On the other hand, when I took church in lights or sound, I had different experiences. Because drama cannot exist without lights and sound. Do you have the same feeling as I had? Lastly, I think that this festival was a success because of your power, not only mine. Thanks to all of you for your support. Thank you very much.